morning everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Leaf Classes. I am Anjali. Today we will be doing the programs based on library classes. For library classes we have already done 3 videos, and my advice to you that do watch those videos before starting with the programs. The link is given in the description box, you may check that. Now from this topic you get questions in section A as well as in section B. Section B, 115 marks question will be there, and in section A around 2 to 4 marks questions are always asked from this topic. So let us start with the programming portion of library classes. And for section A you can refer to previous year questions video of this topic. So let us start with programs. The first program says, to enter a letter, change the case of the entered letter and display the new letter and its ASCII code. And the sample input, if it is A, if I have entered capital A, output should be small a and the ASCII code of the output character, right? So first we have to input a letter. Children, whenever we have to input anything, whether it is integer value, character value, string, any value, then your program must begin with import statement where you will include java.util.scanner package. And then you know that program is written within the body of the class. So class, toggle, always try to give the relevant name. Then main function, public static void main, and the first thing which we have to do is to create the scanner object so that we can use all the scanner functions. So here, enter a letter. How to input a character? Letter is a character. How to input that? The function is sc.next, sc is the object name, .next.caret(0). You can refer to input in Java video, how to input different data type values. Now this I have entered in ch variable. Now children, although I have written here enter a letter, but we cannot hold the hands of somebody that no, you don't enter question mark. If somebody enters question mark or 1 or comma, then what is to be done? We will simply display the message that the entered character is not a letter. So first of all, after entering the character, we have to check whether it is a letter or not. If it is a letter, then we will proceed. Otherwise, we will simply display the message that the entered character is not a letter. So first we have to check. Here we can check like this, character functions you will be using. Children, again it's my request, go to the second video of library classes where all the functions are given and you will be using those functions in library classes programming. If character dot is letter, which variable you want to check, ch, is not equals to true, that means it is not a letter, right? Is not equals to true, or you can write equals to false. So here you will print system dot out dot println not a letter, not a letter, and else. Now when it will come to else, when this condition will be true, that means the entered character will be letter, then only it will come to else block. For else we have to check again, what? That if it is uppercase letter or lowercase letter. So it will come to else when it is a letter. Now here we will check again using the function, if character dot is uppercase, character dot is uppercase, ch is equals to true. If this is equals to true, then we will convert this to lowercase. For that I can take another variable, say ch1 equals to character dot to lowercase of CH. So if it is capital, you are converting it to lowercase and storing it in variable CH1, and you will print system.out.println. We will print this converted character, and we have to print its ASCII value also. So for printing the ASCII value, we will be using typecasting. So here I want to convert character into int. So I will be using int within bracket ch1. ch1 is the small case character of ch, and int of ch1 will give you the ASCII code. Suppose the entered value is capital A, that is stored in ch, then ch1 will be character.2 lowercase of ch. So ch1 will be small a, and you will print small a, and int of ch1, that is 97, will be printed. Else. Now if it is uppercase, we have done this much. Else. That means it will come to else when it is lowercase. So what you will do, you have to convert this to uppercase. Character dot to uppercase function will be used here, and then again we will use print statements to display the converted character and its ASCII code system.out.println of int of ch1. This we can, children, do only one statement here and then display both the statements together. So anyways, you can do. So this is my else block is over here. This all we have to do when this condition is false. So after closing this, you will close main and then you will close class. Just again I am telling you how to do this. You have to input a letter. Although the message is given, but in case the user does not enter a letter, so if is letter is not equals to true, that means the entered letter is, entered character is not a letter, then you will print not a letter and it will not go to else block. It will come here, it will close main, only one message will be displayed. Else, if it is a letter, then it will be checked whether it is uppercase. If it is uppercase, it will be converted to lowercase. It will display that, ASCII value of that will be displayed. Else, if the letter is there but it is not in uppercase, that means it is in lowercase. So we will convert that to uppercase, display it and display its ASCII value. So children, if you see here, we have used isLetter one function, isUpperCase two function, two lowercase and two uppercase. 4-5 functions are used in this program. So please go through the functions, and we will be doing more programs and practice sessions also. So very simple, just go step by step, and I know all of you will be able to do this. So let's start with the next question. The next question is to write a program to display the uppercase letters and its ASCII codes side by side in two columns. The sample output says uppercase letters are written here, A, B, C, D up to capital Z, and their ASCII code. ASCII code of A is 65, B is 66, Y is 89, Z is 90. Now here, from A to Z, we know we have total 26 letters, right? Now, we are not going to use 26 print statements to display the letter and its ASCII code. So what we will be doing, if we have to repeat the process again and again, yes, we always use the looping construct. So here we will use the looping construct to display these letters and its corresponding ASCII code. Now here I have written the message. Simple message is here displayed using print statement uppercase letter backslash t. Backslash t is tab character, which gives a tab space and ASCII code. Now we will be using the for loop I am using here. You can use while loop, do while loop, any loop you can use. Now, in for loop, what is the first numeric value here is 65 and the last value is 90. So, we will take the loop from starting from 65, I less than equals to 90, I plus plus. And here we will be printing that. We will be printing the character value of this looping variable, and 65 to 90 is the ASCII value only. So here we will print system.out.println. Why println? Because every output I want on the next line. So here you will print the character value. So here how you will convert character 65 to its character value using char. Char within bracket, kiska character chahiye? Of I. Char of 65 will give you capital A. Plus backslash T, backslash T. I can write here twice backslash T because here so much of gap is there because my heading is little big. So you can write, otherwise it will give you, it will not be in proper alignment. So, char of I will give you the capital letter of this ASCII code, and then we want simple this number. So, char of I, that is char of 65, will give you capital A, backslash T will give you two tab spaces in between, and plus I will give you 65. So, A 65, and that's it in the loop. Next time the value of I will be incremented, it will become 66. So char of 66 will be capital B, two tab spaces, and then 66. Like this, it will continue from 65 to 90, that is from capital A to capital Z. And this is your for loop, and then you close main and then you close class. So very simple program, very easy. Please children, do practice these programs. The next question is to write a program to generate the following pattern: A, A, B, A, B, C, A, B, C, D, A, B, C, D, E, like this. So, all of you know that these type of patterns are always generated using nested loop. So, it's my advice to go to the nested looping video and just go through that. It is very important, and always you get pattern based questions. It can be numeric pattern, it can be character based pattern, or from the strings also it can be asked. So let us write the program. We know that the ASCII value of A is 65, 66, 67, 68, 69. So you should be knowing the ASCII value of the letters capital A to capital Z, small a to small z. It is must to learn. Now, whenever we have this type of pattern, we will be using nested for loop, and here outer loop is there and you have one inner loop. To make your program more easy, I am going to tell you a trick over here. See here how you want all A in the first column. And children, we know whenever we have different values in each column of our row, then the printing variable is from the inner loop, right? Like here in this we have A, B, C, D, E, A, B, C, D. In one row, if you see each column has a different value, then the looping variable will be always the inner variable, right? So here we will be printing now J. Every time in the entire row, the printing is starting from A. That is, the ASCII value should start from 65. And what is the last value of in each column? It is E, then D, C, B, A, A, B, C, D, E, like this. So it is changing, right? So first time, what is your last value? First is also 65, last is 65. Second time 65 to 66. Last time 65 to 69. So that is changing. So that is our variable. That is I, and every time we are getting the next value. So it will be J++. Now, what should be the value of I for the first time? We want 65 to 65. So, I should be 65 here. What should be the last value, last row? 65 to 69. So, that means I should be 69 in the last row. So, when I is 65, J will go from 65 to 65. When I is 66, J will again start from 65 to 66. I is 67, 65 to 67. And we don't want 65 or 66 or 67 to be printed. What we want? We want to print their character values. So, for doing that, we will be writing char of J. Char of J will give you the character value of this ASCII code. And here I have used print statement. So, one row will be in the all the columns of first row in the same row. And then once your first row is over, then we want to come to the next line. For that, we will be using system.out.println without any variable will shift the cursor to the next line. So see here, when I is 65, J is 65 to 65, char of 65 is A. A is displayed. println will take you to the next line. I will become 66 and J will again become 65. Char of J, char of 65 is A. J will be 66, char of 66 is B. Loop is over. println will take you to the next line. I will become 67. J will again start from 65. Char of 65, 66, 67. This entire loop, inner loop will be over first. And then println will take you to the next line. Then for 68, A, B, C, D. And then for 69, A, B, C, D, E. Like that it will be printed. Now your nested loop is over. Then you close main and then you close class. It is very simple, very easy. Please go through the nested looping programs once again. You will find this also very easy. The next question says to input a character and display next 10 characters in the ASCII table. If the sample input is A, we have to display starting from B, C, D, E till K. Next 10 characters. These are the next 10 characters. Right? It is not necessary that it has to be letter. It can be any character, and from the ASCII table we have to display the next 10 characters according to that. So I have taken import statement because we have to input a character. Then you have created scanner object and display the message enter a character, and we have entered the character in ch variable. The statement says sc.next.caret(0). Now, first we have to find the ASCII value. Children, first understand the logic and then we will write the program. The ASCII value of the entered character, suppose it is 65, right? Now, first thing is to find the ASCII code, and then starting from the next of this ASCII code, you have to display all the values 66, 67, 68, like this till 75, all next ASCII code characters you have to display. So the first thing which we have to do is to find the ASCII value. Say I have taken the variable M. How you find the ASCII value? Simple. Typecasting int of ch will give you the ASCII value of ch, and it is stored in m variable. Now we can take a loop int I is equals to 1, I less than equals to 10. Why looping statement? Because we want to repeat the steps 10 times. So we will not be using 10 print statements. Rather, we will use the looping construct. Now here what I can do, say this is 65, ASCII value of A is 65 here. First I will increase that ASCII code by 1 and then display the character value of that ASCII code. So for doing that, I can write M++. Say if it is 65, M++ will become 66. And then here you write system.out.println. And simply you use char of M. Char of M will give you the character value of this ASCII code. And that we have to do, display the next 10 characters from the ASCII table, right? Next 10 characters you have to display according to the ASCII table. You don't have to display the ASCII code. You have to display the next 10 characters. So here you will be closing the loop. So when it is 1, first time it is incremented, you are displaying the value. Second time, third time, like this, you will continue. And then you will close main and then you will close class. For today, this much only. Children, let me know if you want more programming practice on the topic library classes. Do comment in the comment section. And it's my request to each one of you to do the programming practice properly. Wherever you are not able to understand, please let me know through comment section. Those who haven't subscribed the channel yet, please do subscribe and press the bell icon so that you get notifications for all the videos and no important topic is missed by you. You can join us on our Telegram channel also. The link is given in the description box. Keep practicing, keep doing programs, keep working hard. God bless you, children.